Welcome back to my channel. I am so excited to be sharing my ofrenda this year to celebrate one of the most beautiful Mexican traditions that you all probably know as Day of the Dead, or in Spanish, Día de los Muertos. So for all my non-Mexican followers, Día de los Muertos is a celebration for Mexico when families gather to honor the memory of deceased loved ones, and this all happens from October 31st through November 2nd. Every year, we set up this beautiful altar to guide our loved ones home, and we welcome them with different offerings such as their favorite foods, water, even sometimes alcohol. So I really hope that you guys enjoy watching, and of course, this video will not be monetized as I felt that it would be wrong to do so. But if you are new here, please consider subscribing. It would mean the absolute world to me, and your guys' support seriously allows me to continue posting videos like these. So it means the world when you guys do show the support in my videos by commenting, liking, and of course subscribing. But anyways, we're gonna go ahead and hop right into this video. So Día de los Muertos is highly recognized by its beautiful yellow and orange hues of marigold flower. It's also known as Cempasuchil, and the reason why we use these flowers is because their strong scent and their bright colors are believed to help guide the spirits to their altars. And they do smell very, very strong, I'm not gonna lie, especially when I was ripping the flower petals to be able to like lay it out around the altar. My hands smelled very strongly of cempasúchil. And also, if you actually ever go to Mexico and you visit a cemetery there, you will smell the cempasúchil everywhere. It really brought me back to being in Mexico because that's what it smells like. So another very important element for an ofrenda is levels. So ofrendas can be made of several levels, and in my case, I made mine of two that represent the earth and the sky. The most common one though is a seven level ofrenda, and the seven levels basically represent the seven destinations that a soul must cross to be able to rest eternally. There's a lot more to it, but that's basically like the simple explanation of it. Unfortunately, I don't have the resources to do so, plus I also have cats and a toddler, so I'd probably have a little bit of a nightmare on my hands if I did try to do a seven level one. But as you guys can see here, I'm kind of working on the placement of everything. I added beans in here, of course, to represent beans. My grandpa that passed away, he really loved his beans, so I added that to my ofrenda. And then along with this, I also added pan de muerto, and this bread basically has a meaning behind it. So the circle right in the middle of the bread represents a skull. The elongated pieces, they represent the bones, and the long little sections also symbolize the tears that we shed for those that have passed away. So it definitely has a meaning, and I love it. It tastes delicious. It's this like very delicious bread, super soft, and it's covered in sugar, so it's super, super good. And then, of course, the very, very iconic white candles. The white candles represent purity, and you'll see these be used all over Mexico. It's always at an ofrenda. You definitely don't want to do a different colored candle. There's just different meanings. You kind of have to research about ofrendas and what everything means, because there's just so much to it. And then finally, I started adding all of my cempasúchil petals, and then also I added some candy because my grandpa loved candy. He, for some reason, always had candy on him. It was so funny. My grandma would always wonder where he would pull it out from. She would go searching for it. She could never find it, but my grandpa somehow always managed to pull out some candy, and we'd sit with him and eat it. And it's just a very, very favorite memory of mine because my grandma just couldn't figure out where it was coming from. But anyways, yeah, so I added candy for him, and then I finally removed the pan de muerto from the plastic now that I was sure that that's where I wanted it to be placed. And then I actually decided to switch the beans to this smaller container just because it was taking up too much space and it wasn't fitting properly. So I switched it over to this one. And then on this corner, also for my grandpa, he loved papaya and he loved eating it with sugar. So I added papaya for him because he was always eating that. And then, of course, the one thing that I am missing that I didn't add in this video, but on top of adding the sugar, I am missing salt. Salt is very important. It just helps, I believe, to ward off spirits or bad spirits. And there's a meaning behind it, but I will insert that in the description below because I can't remember off the top of my head. But I am missing salt and I will add it after this video. And then finally, I just added some little lights to top it off. I just really love this tradition, you guys. And if you guys follow me on Instagram, you saw that I mentioned that you don't need to be Mexican to celebrate Dia de los Muertos or to even make an ofrenda. And if you're even considering like making one, just make sure that you research a little bit about it, learn about what everything means, and make one. You don't need to be Mexican to do this. We love sharing our culture. And if you feel like you want to honor your loved ones that have passed away, go for it. We love when other people celebrate with us. So feel free to do it. Just make sure to educate yourself, of course, and to make it properly. And if you are looking for anything like the pan de muerto and all that, just find your local Mexican shop, your market or whatever, and you will find everything there. I promise. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed and I will see you in my next video.
Love for each other.